Hello, good morning. I'm right here. Today I've got a bit of a project. I've got a whole lot of dried flowers from past floral arrangements. I've got some olives. It's even got some olives on it. I've got eucalyptus. I've got some rosebuds. Those are still, well, sort of fresh. They have their life as a vase flower is gone, but hopefully they'll find a second life in my wreath. I've got some berries, some sedum, some moss. If all goes wrong, I've got some plastic flowers, and I have a it's well. I've got these little golden. And I've got some for tools. I have this tape, golden tape, for the to attach the lights. I've got scissors, secateurs, a knife just in case, some wire, this yarn. I think the wire might be a bit rough on the dried flowers, so I think I'm gonna use yarn. This little gray. I've got some ivy needles, and I've got obviously the wreath. I've got this one in two sizes. This one I made yesterday, and I learned a lot. So hopefully today is gonna go better. I'm gonna do the big one. Oh yeah, they are both from Rowan and Wren, in case you're thinking of buying them. I'm gonna put the link in the description. It's just a very simple golden hoop with the attachment for hanging it. For the first step, I'm gonna take everything out of the vases and cut it down to size, and I'll see you in a bit. So I've cut up as much as I'll need. If not, there's more. I'm gonna start with attaching the lights to the wreath. First of all, untangling. So I want the battery pack at the base, so I'm gonna start with that. Hopefully, I'm gonna find the end of the, yeah. I'm now attaching the thread that I'll use to bind the plants to the wreath with a little knot. And then all that's left to do is bind the wreath. Just make little bunches out of the greenery, hold them to the wreath, and then wrap them with the thread, just over and over and over, going around until you're done. To hide the camera pack, I'm positioning the moss over it. For that, I'm gonna thread an ivy needle into the yarn that I've used. It's bit of a squeeze, but okay, just a yes. And then I'm pushing the moss onto the needle. You really want something to cover your floor there because it's crumbly. So that's the first part. And the second bit. And then I use two more ivy needles to attach the two pieces together. Now to embellish the moss, I'm using the roses. And here I decided to make the yarn a bit of a feature. So I'm going to lay the roses on top of the moss and then use generous helpings of the gray yarn to bind them to the moss and make everything a little bit more stable. Now I'm turning the wreath over to hide the knot in the yarn on the back. And now all that's left to do is finish the wreath. So just make little bunches of the greenery, which by the magic of cinema, a whole lot of olive green cuttings have appeared. So make little bunches and then wrap the gray yarn around them and finish the wreath. That's really all that's left to do. So there's a few more seconds of this exciting footage. And then I'll show you the final product. So, sorry if the picture is a bit jerky, I'm filming with my phone. I just wanted to show you the finished wreath. And final thoughts, I now realize why people bind a wreath when the flowers are fresh and then wait for it to dry. It's been an absolute mess. But I really love the result. So, say hello to the presentation elk. I inherited this thing from my grandmother. I never knew what to do with it, so I'm using it for this. And oh, I just realized that this thing is surprisingly anatomically accurate. So this is the finished wreath. It's been quite the adventure putting this thing together, but I really like it. Like the dark purples of the berries and the sedum together with the sort of green-gray purple of the eucalyptus and the green and grey of the olives. It's just gorgeous. Well, I think so. Sorry to pat myself on the back like this, but I'm very happy with it. So, this is sort of my transition wreath. I don't like spending money on flowers, so I put this together and I'll have it up until the spring flowers are coming in and I can have fresh flowers from the garden in the house again. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. If not, you can learn from my mistakes. So if you enjoyed this, do subscribe. If you have any comments and any tips on what to do better, this is my first sort of crafting video, so I'm sure I've made a lot of mistakes. I'm quite excited to put the footage together. But yeah, say goodbye to the elk. All right, thank you so much for watching. Have a lovely day and goodbye.